In the first numerical, a potentiometer wire is 10 meter long and has a resistance of 18 ohm. So note down the particulars. This is length of wire, length of potentiometer wire. This is resistance of potentiometer wire. And then you have been given, it is connected to a battery of EMF 5 volt of internal resistance 2 ohm. So note down, this is EMF of driver cell because no other cell is mentioned. And its resistance is 2 ohm. This is R internal. Okay, we'll have to find out potential gradient. So potential gradient has got one formula as this, but here we'll be using, as per the given particulars, what are given, we'll be picking up the suitable formula, and the formula suitable is E driver upon R external plus R wire into R wire upon length of potentiometer wire. So if you see, how many quantities do we have? We have E driver, EMF of driver cell, yes we have, and R wire, it is resistance of potentiometer wire, length of wire is given in meters, and R wire is again given in meters, sorry, 18 ohm is R wire. So the only quantity which we feel is not given is R external, but here this internal resistance of cell will act as external resistance. It means the any resistance which is other than resistance of potentiometer wire in the upper circuit will be considered as external resistance. So this value will be substituted here. So all the quantities we know, substitute and find out the answer. Answer I have mentioned here. You can compare your mathematical calculation with the given answer. In the next question, a potentiometer wire is supplied a constant voltage of 3 volt. So a cell of EMF, this cell is your driver cell. A cell of EMF 1.08 volt is balanced by the voltage across 216 centimeter. Find the total length of the potentiometer wire. So we'll have to see that this cell is getting balanced against this length. So this is my V balanced and this is my L balanced. This voltage is getting balanced against this length. So we can find out 1K from here, one potential gradient from here using the formula according to the particulars given. So we can use this formula and we can find out K. Now the question is, we have to find out the total length of the potentiometer across the total length. If total length of potentiometer wire is used as balancing length, then what will be balanced? Your balancing voltage will be E of the driver cell. So 3 volt is to be balanced against total length, and we have to find out total length. So 1K can be found from here, and from second set it is V balance is 3 and L balance is, we don't know, we have to calculate. So you can equate these 2K and you can find out capital L, this is length of the whole wire. So here you know both the values, here you know one value, only one value is unknown, which is to be calculated. A length of potentiometer wire is being calculated as 600 centimeter. Let us see the next question. Two cells of EMF E1 and E2 with EMF E1 is greater than E2 are connected as shown in the figure. When a potentiometer is connected between A and B, the balancing length is 300 centimeter. So note down the particulars. Case 1, when it is connected between A and B, balancing length I have noted first, which is 300 centimeter. Now what is my voltage balance? What is my V balance? So we'll look at the diagram and we'll see, when we will take A and B, then which cell is there in consideration? Only E1. So I have noted down that V balanced in first case is E1. So you can find out 1K from here. See, I have written V balanced by L balanced. It is E1 by 300 centimeter. Now coming, let us read further. On connecting the same potentiometer between A and C, the balancing length is 100. So case 2, when it is connected between A and C, again you can note down the balancing length, which is 100 centimeter. But what is the V balance? What is the voltage balance getting, a voltage getting balanced against this length? So let us see, between A and C, both the cells are coming and they are opposing each other. They are not supporting each other because same terminals are connected to each other. You can see negative is connected to negative. So they are opposing. In opposing, net voltage will be E1 minus E2 or E2 minus E1, whichever is larger. So here E1 is larger. So the V balance will be E1 minus E2. Okay, because opposite, same polarities are connected. So 1K you can find out from here. It is V balanced upon L balanced. Now 2Ks are there with you, this equation and this equation. You can equate them. लाइक आई हैव इक्वेटेड ई वन बाय 300, दिस वॉज माई फर्स्ट पार्ट वेन ई वन वॉज गेटिंग बैलेंस अगेंस्ट 300 सेंटीमीटर एंड इन सेकेंड केस ई वन माइनस ई टू दिस इज माई वी बैलेंस दिस इज माई वोल्टेज बैलेंस एंड बैलेंसिंग लेंथ कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग बैलेंसिंग लेंथ इज 100. यू कैन इक्वेट दैम, यूज मैथमेटिक्स, डू क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन, ओके एंड यू कैन फाइंड आउट द रेशियो ऑफ ई वन बाई ई टू विच इज द क्वेश्चन. गेटिंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर नेक्स्ट, let us read the question. The null points for two primary cells E1 and E2 connected in the manner are 120 cm and 300 cm. Find E1 by E2. So we'll have to see there are two configuration. When you use this configuration, your balancing length is 120. So note it down. This is my case 1 and my balancing length is 120 centimeter, but we'll have to find out what is V balance in this case, what is the balanced voltage in this case. So you can see in this case, in this particular case, same polarities are being connected, right? So again, voltages are getting subtracted, EMFs are getting subtracted. So E1 minus E2 will be the V balanced in this case when balancing length is 120 centimeter. So you can use the formula of K, potential gradient. It is always V balanced by L balanced. So substitute L balance and be ready with one equation. See, I am ready with one equation. Okay, cross multiply and get this equation. Now case number 2, let us erase it. Yes, in case number 2, your balancing length is 300. So note it down. This is my balancing length 300 centimeter. But what is my voltage balance? So here you can see opposite polarities are being connected. This is negative of first cell, it is connected to positive of second cell. So, both the cells are supporting each other. So, net voltage balance will be addition of the two EMFs. So, V balance is this. Substitute in value of potential gradient. V balance is this and L balance is this. Substitute. Okay. So, two equations are ready. Two mathematical equations, two linear equations are ready and two variables are there, E1 and E2. You all can solve E1 and E2. Okay, two equations you can solve and you can see I have got E1 like this. Okay, E2 you can obtain. I have not written here. Okay, now we'll have to find out the ratio. Ratio has to be 7 by 3. Okay, one more question that they have asked. Find the position of null point for cell E1. So, I have shown you that the value of E1 will come like this. So, this is my V balanced. This is my K potential gradient. So, what is this? This is my L balance. So, cell E1 is getting balanced against a length of 210 centimeter. This is my second answer. Okay. Okay. In this question, first is to draw the circuit diagram. Okay. So, we'll go through the question statement properly. There is a potentiometer, a standard cell of EMF 5 volt and of negligible resistance maintains a steady current through the potentiometer wire of length this. So, this is the diagram that I have drawn. Okay. And this is your driver cell of 5 volt and length you can mention as 5 meter. Two primary cells of EMF E1 and E2 are joined in series with same polarity and opposite polarity. There are two cases. One case is this and one case is this. Here they have been connected with same polarity, negative to negative. Here it is negative to positive. So here they are supporting, here they are opposing. There are two balancing lengths, this and this. So you can see when they are supporting, voltage is more. So balancing length is more. So 350 is for this and 50 is for this. We have to draw the circuit diagram. This is a circuit diagram. You can draw it properly. And then we have to find out the values of EMFs of two cells. So, first of all, pay attention here. They have given this balance, this voltage, 5 volt. So, always keep in mind that a driver cell's voltage will be balanced against entire length. So, this is driver cell's voltage, and this is V balanced. It will be balanced against the entire length, that is 5 meter. So, you can find out the value of potential gradient from here and keep it in hand to be used further in the numerical. Now, when balancing length is 350, or you can say 50, let us pick 50. When balancing length is 50, then you know that the voltage balance will be less, that is opposite polarity, same polarity wala. So, it is E1 minus E2. Keep it ready. K you know, you can substitute. So one equation will be ready. You can substitute K. Now in second case, when your balanced voltage will be E1 plus E2, then balancing length is 350. Again, you can form the equation. Substitute here K. Two equations will be there. You can solve the both equations to find out the value of E1 and E2. Answer is written here. You all can check. Getting to the next question. A 10 meter long wire of uniform cross section of this. So these two particulars, please note down. This is R wire. One is R wire. This is length wire. This is length of wire. And this is R wire. Note it down. Then note down particular things. Further things. This is your E driver. Okay. External resistance. This is external resistance in the diagram as well. So you can note it down. Now, they are saying that EMF E is balanced at 600. So, this is my V balance and this is my L balance. Okay. So, my V balance is E and L balance is this. And the quantities which were given for in the beginning of the question, I have used this formula of K to find out K. E driver upon R external, which is given, plus R wire, which is given. Then R wire upon L wire, all the quantities are given. That means I have K. So sort it out, find out K. And now they are saying that this EMF E is getting balanced at 600 centimeters. So this is my V balance and L balance. You can find out one more formula of K. Put both equal, only unknown quantity is this. You can solve it. Getting to the next question. In the circuit diagram, okay, read it properly and note down. This is wire's resistance, R wire, 15 ohm, I've noted. Length 1 meter. So, this is length 1 meter, this is L wire. You can write little big. This is L wire. Now, they're saying this EMF E1 is 2 volt. Okay, EMF E1 is 2 volt. This is driver cell though. So, driver cell is 2 volt, internal resistance negligible and resistance R. R is connected here. Okay, further you read, this 75 millivolt is getting balanced at 30 centimeter. You read it properly, you will get to know that this EMF is getting balanced at 30 centimeter. So, that means 75 millivolt is V balance and length balance is this. So, using the other formula of potential gradient, which is V balance by L balance, we can find out K. So, V can be ready with K. Okay. One more formula of K is there. This E driver, this wala formula. We can substitute all things. How many things do we have? We have E driver, we have R wire. We have length wire, we have R wire. We don't have R external. Okay. So, from here and here, put K equal, the only unknown quantities are external, it can be found. So, first question is to find R. So, you can calculate R by equating the two values of K. Then, second question is, if E2 is 300 millivolt, what will be the balancing point? Which is damn simple. If this is your V balanced, what is your L balance? Your question is this. So, substitute V balance, L balance is to be found. K you have already found from case 2 because here 75 millivolt was getting balanced against this length. So, K is to be used here and you can find out L balance for this cell, 300 millivolt. Answer is mentioned, you all can check. Getting to the next question, the length of potential meter wire, please note on the particular. Okay, it is connected to a battery of constant EMF. Then they are saying, for a given Leclanché cell, the position of zero deflection is 100 cm. Okay, if length is 8 meter instead of 5 meter, what will be the position of zero deflection? So, we can do it by unitary method. If length is 5 meter, length of potentiometer is wire is 5 meter, then the balancing length is obtained at 100 cm. If it is 1 meter, use unitary method. If it is 8 meter, you can report the answer. Getting to next, a potentiometer wire of length 100 cm, note down the particular. This is the first job that you need to do sincerely. This is resistance wire, It is connected in series with a resistance and a battery of 2 volt. So this is your upper circuit, that is E driver is 2 volt, and some resistance is there which we don't know. Okay, now 10 millivolt is balanced against this. So this is your V balance, this is your L balance. You can find out K from here. Okay, so 1K can be obtained from here and here, and 1K can be written from E driver's formula. The only unknown quantities again are external. You can find it out, and I have solved it duly. You can check the solution. This I will be sharing. Getting to next question is important. This is AB. AB means potentiometer wire. So length of wire is given. 10 ohm is the resistance, or resistance wire is given. Calculate the potential gradient. First question is to find out the potential gradient. So look at the diagram carefully. This is your E driver. This is your R external, and rest of the quantities, that is L wire and R wire, are given to you. E driver and R external are to be picked from the circuit diagram. So we know this formula. Substitute and be ready with the value of potential gradient. So one part can be sorted. That is substitution based numerical. Second part is length AO. We need to find out when galvanometer shows no deflection. So length AO. Now at AO, who is getting balanced? Secondary circuit is getting balanced. Okay, secondary voltage is getting balanced. So from here we will find out, this is your EMF, this is your one resistance, this is your second resistance. Okay, so we have EMF. Okay, and these are two resistances which I have added to find out net resistance. So current can be obtained. Now using this current, I am finding the voltage drop across any arm, upper or lower. You can find out in lower arm. Lower arm is only containing 0.3 ohm. Right. So using this current, which is found by EMF upon net resistance, using this current and this resistor, I into R, you can find out the voltage drop. I into R, I is there as 1. So this is your voltage drop. That is, this is V balance. And we have to find out what is the corresponding balancing length, because we have to find out AO, A to O. What is AO? So this is V balance, this is L balance, which is to be found, and K you know. So please substitute value of K, and V balance is 0.3, L balance can be found. Answers are mentioned here. Getting to next question. A cell gives a balance at 85 centimeter. Okay, when the terminals of cells are shorted through this resistor, external resistor, the balance point is this. Okay, so we have to recall the formula of internal resistance of the cell. So this is your second application of potentiometer to find out the internal resistance of cell. This is a full-fledged topic whose formula comes as L1 by L2 minus 1 into external resistance. Okay, what is L1? It is a balancing length of cell. What is L2? It is a balancing length of cell when some resistor is used. So this is your L2, and when some resistor is used, resistor is here. You can substitute the value, and directly it is a substitution based numerical. Getting to this, this is a conceptual. We have to find out which potentiometer will be preferred, this one or this one. So you can see slope of A is greater than slope of B. So I've written slope of A is greater than slope of B. Slope is perpendicular by base, that is V by L of A is greater than V by L of B. Now what is V by L? Is potential gradient. Potential gradient of A is more than potential gradient of B. Now we know that sensitivity is more when potential gradient is low. So we'll be preferring B because it is more sensitive. Getting to the next question. In a potentiometer circuit, whatever, okay, resistance R is increased, then what happens to balance point? This is increased. So R wire you are increasing. Yes. So what will happen to K? K will reduce. K will get reduced. Okay. Now K is equal to V balance by L balance. This is second formula. So if K is getting reduced, balancing length will increase. So balance point will shift towards B. Again, listen. There are two formulas for K. One is by E driver's method and one is by V balance by L balance. So if you are increasing this external resistance, this is your external resistance which is being increased, When it is increased, your potential gradient will decrease, so length will increase. Okay, so balancing point will shift towards B. Now, when S is decreased, so this S is decreased, this resistance whole purpose is to save galvanometer, so nothing will be changed. It is increased or decreased, its purpose is to save galvanometer. Right. If cell P is replaced by, yani ki driver cell is replaced by another cell whose EMF is less than Q, that is secondary cell. So, this is the necessary condition for the proper working of potentiometer, that the EMF of the driver cell must be greater than EMF of the secondary cell. That is, EMF of P cell must be greater than EMF of Q cell. If they are saying, if it is not so, if it is less, then potentiometer will not work. You can write that the balancing length will be outside the potentiometer wire. We cannot obtain balance point on the potentiometer. Okay, so you can write anything. Getting to this question, we'll have to find out the expression for potential drop per unit length. Potential drop per unit length is what? Is your K. Potential gradient. So how to find it out? It is simple. See, potential can be written as I into R, L as it is. So basically, we have to find out R. L is L, R is R naught, resistance wire, R wire is R naught. So we have just to substitute this I. Now, how to substitute this I? I will be total voltage, that is EMF, and resistance will be resistance of wire. Plus R external. This is your R external. So simply find out the parallel resistance. Sorry. You can see. Here I have found. First of all, I have written the particulars. R wire is R naught. Here it is. Length wire is L. These symbols are allowed. Okay. Now for external resistance, you can find out these two are in parallel. So find it out. This is external resistance. Now see. Your formula, yeah, other formula also you can use. This is E driver wala formula. So, E driver symbol is E, right? Substitute R wire, they have given as R naught. R wire, they have given as R naught. L wire is L and R external you have found. Please take the LCM and report. Get to the next question. This is an NCERT question. Important, it has come in boards once. So, let us see. Resistance, let us find out what is to be found first. So we'll have to derive an expression for the voltage fed into the circuit when the slide is in the middle of the potentiometer, when the jockey is in the mid. Okay, now the resistance of AC, that is potentiometer wire, is R naught, right? Resistance of potentiometer wire is, you can note it down, is R naught, and jockey is in the middle, B point is in the middle. Okay, so what is the resistance of AB portion, that is middle till middle point AB? So it is R naught by 2, because resistance of whole wire AC is R naught. Now you can see this R isn't in parallel, is in parallel with this. Okay, let me erase and show it again. This R is in parallel with this resistance, which is R naught by 2. Remaining resistance is also R naught by 2. But these two are in parallel. So this is what I have written. RAB is in parallel with R. RAB is R naught by 2. So please find it out using parallel formula that everyone knows. Substitute. Do mathematics properly. Now this resistance is your RP, which is the result of these two in parallel. Okay, now this is in series with R naught by 2, remaining resistance. So, I found RP, which is the answer of these two, right? This is your RP. It is in series with this R naught by 2. So, you can use series formula now. RP and R naught by 2, remaining resistance are in series. So, RP is this. So, I found R net, R series you can say. Substitute and do mathematics properly, algebra properly, and find out a proper expression. So I'm ready with R net. Okay, so R net I have, this is my R net, right, which is the result of series combination of rp and r naught by 2, and rp is parallel combination of these two. So these, you know, this is my net voltage, this is my net resistance, which I'm ready with. Now I can find out current. So net voltage is V, expression is V, and net resistance, whatever expression, take LCM properly and substitute. So I'm ready with I. Now I have to report potential drop till midpoint. So current I have obtained, please substitute, but resistance I will take till midpoint, that is these two are resistance. Okay, this resistance, that is RP. An expression of RP is ready. Please substitute current and RP. Okay, take LCM, do algebra properly, and this is going to be the answer. It's an important question. Getting to next. The length of potential meter wire is this. Note down particulars very calmly. It carries a current of 40 milliampere. Question is different. First time they have given current. Okay. For a cell of EMF 2 volt and internal resistance 10 ohm, note it down. Some EMF is given, some internal resistance is given. Balancing length is this. So this is your V balance. This is your L balance. You can find out K. So be ready with K. You know potential gradient now. Okay. What is the first question? What is the resistance of whole wire? So to find out the resistance of whole wire, this value of K we know will be using obviously, and here we will open K from upper cell, upper circuit, V balance by L balance. Okay. Now voltage can be written as current into resistance wire, obviously resistance of potential wire, and L wire. Okay. So now current is given in the upper circuit. They have given the value 40 milliampere. So I've substituted. R wire is to be found. Resistance of wire, resistance of potential meter wire is to be found. And length of wire they have given. Substitute. Only one quantity is unknown. You can find it out. Okay. See, if you don't know that how this is open, K to this we know. V balance to this we know. Every V is open as I into R. And because it is upper circuit, so it is I into resistance of wire. Full wire. Now coming to case 2. See, for case 2 I have written the statement once again. I have shown the statement once again. For case 2, we have to find out reading of the voltmeter. Now see, K is already ready. From here, this EMF is getting balanced against this length. Now, they are saying if a voltmeter is connected across the cell, the balancing length is decreased by 10. So when voltmeter is connected, balancing length is decreased by 10. So L balance is decreased by 10. Yani ki earlier it was 500. See, this was 500. Now it is decreased by 10. So now it is 490 centimeter. And what is balance? Okay, we don't know what is balance. This is some terminal potential difference. So again, formula is ready. Right. This K can be put equal to this. So V can be found, which is the reading of the voltmeter. Second case is to be done like this. Now getting to third case, which is resistance of voltmeter. So, what is V voltage read by voltmeter? We are ready. Second case. Okay, write it here. This TPD, terminal potential difference, can be written as this. This is the equation that we know, which holds good for the connection between terminal potential difference and EMF. So, find out V. Now, EMF of cell. Which cell? Not driver. Secondary wala. So, you see, EMF of cell is given. Internal resistance is given. Okay, so let us substitute. EMF we have substituted, internal resistance we have substituted, wait for current, how to open current, net EMF, which is this, upon net resistance. In net resistance, this external is to be found, which is resistance of voltmeter, and internal resistance is given. I have used this equation, E is equal to V plus IR, V is equal to E minus IR. I know E 2 volt, I know this. Yes, this can be opened as net EMF upon net opposition. This we know. This is to be calculated, which is resistance of voltmeter. That's all. Thank you.